I'd like to welcome everybody to Outside the Games. Thank you so much for coming into our program. And we have an student athlete that has come in today. Her name is Sierra Cook. She's class of 2026 out of Palm Beach Gardens, Florida area, Dwyer High School. She has a 4.0. She's third base and outfield. And I tell you, Sierra Cook, thank you so much for coming into Outside the Games. How are you?
I'm good. I just finished one of my tournaments. We just had one in Newberry. And so coming off of that, I'm a little sore, but I'm good. And I had weightlifting today, so my legs are killing me, but it's good. We're good.
Oh my goodness. Yeah. No, I could imagine. You have a game and then you got legs. You had to do a weight workout. So, wow, that's something. Well, we always start the program off here, Sierra, that of family. And really, how would you as a student athlete define family for you? Take us through that.
So my family, we're all really close. So I have my mom and I have two siblings. I have an older sister and a younger brother. And then I have my two babies, my cats. So my parents, they do everything they can to help me succeed. And they truly are my best friends. Like, I genuinely don't know where I would be without them. And so my dad takes me to every single tournament. But my mom did take me to one in South Carolina this summer, and it was really fun. But most of the time she's home with my siblings because she's a teacher, so she has to, like, take her time for that. But she always texts me, and she's like, how's your game? Da-da-da-da, and all this stuff. But it's really sweet. And so, yeah, they do everything they can to support me, like, truly. Like, it's insane, like, the amount of time they put into softball for me, just because they know how much, like, I care about it. And if not as much as I care, they care more. But I don't know if they care more, because it's like, I care a lot, but they care just as much as I do about softball, and they want me to succeed, and they want the best for me. So it's really good having a relationship like that.
Yeah, I mean, really, when you look at it, there's the common goal there between you, between the parents, and you as their child, and in a sense of where they know you have a goal, and so together, your goal is to do the most you can do, not only in the classroom, but also, what are the opportunities as far as softball goes? And I think that's the thing they want to be able to give you, is give you every opportunity. And I think of sacrifice as something parents do a lot, is for their children, is to get them as many opportunities as possible to see where they fall and to see where they go, in the sense of the opportunities that they get from the sacrifices that are made.
I mean, yeah, they've both sacrificed so much time. Like, I don't know if they knew in their lives that they would be spending this much time at softball fields, because it's insane. Like, on Saturday, we had a 15-hour day, and we were all exhausted, but we spent all day at the fields, and we were just working and working and working and working. And so it's like they literally sacrifice everything for me. I don't know how they do it, but they do.
You know, and speaking of mentorship, you know, mentors come into play because they're outside of that family unit. They're kind of that part of that village, as we've always said. A lot of people speak on this village that surrounds the student athlete, that's there for the student athlete, but mentors are outside. And take me through some of your mentors, how they've helped you, Sierra, to be a good student athlete.
So a lot of softball, obviously, for everyone is mental, but something I personally, a lot of it, when I, like, if I'm ever struggling with softball, it's never the physical part, it's always the mental part, because I am very a mental person with this. Like, it takes a lot for me to, like, break down, but how do I say this? If I'm, like, struggling on the field, it's because I'm not believing in myself as much as I should. I know I'm capable of doing it, and that's something I have to remember. And someone who's always told me, no, you can, is my hitting coach. And my hitting coach is Coach Sam. I've been with him since I was 9 years old. So it's a long time. I'm about to be 16, so almost 7 years with him, and I've hit with him for so long. And he become family. So he always tells me, just breathe, relax, take your time, and know you can. And knowing I can, like that saying, I always repeat that to myself in the box because it's like, in the back of my mind, I know I can, but I have to remind myself. I have to be like, listen, you can do this. You've done this a million times. And another person who has really helped me a lot is one of my assistant coach for my travel team, Coach Eric. He literally, when I tell you that this like person, he has helped me so much. Like, he's just there and he like, sorry, I'm like at a loss for words. I'm like trying to explain this.
Eric's plays a different role though. There's a different role that I think all these mentors play. So he kind of adds another piece to you. What are the some things that he adds to you to help you out?
So he adds a sense of support because I know that no matter what, he's always going to be encouraging me and that he will always have my back through everything. Because so there was one time I had like a rough practice and it was really hard for me to like get through that because it's like when you know you can do something and you're not doing it how you want to, it's really frustrating. And so he was really there for me that practice, and then after practice he told me that he would never give up on me, and that was really sweet. And it like really helps to know that you have someone like that, especially when it's like someone that's plays such a significant role in your like team and like just everything you do, because I'm with him all the time. I have practice like 3 times a week and I play every weekend. So it's like to have someone there that you know will always support you, it's really helpful.
That's big. That's big. I love how you expounded on how these mentors play a role in your life. And that's important because that's your success and how you get successful. It's that road, right? There's a road there. We're going to talk about Dwyer High School, Palm Beach Gardens, Florida. Take outside the games through what Dwyer High School is like, Sierra.
So I absolutely love my school. So I'm not zoned for Dwyer, but I go there for finance. I do finance at the school. It's the FLBS program, and I really love it. And it basically gives opportunities to like kids to like pursue their like dreams of like going into the finance business. And so I know that like you could do, I want to do business and I want to do law. So it gets me there. It gets me to that point. And basically Dwyer, everyone there is like super nice. Like there's no like admin that you would go to and you'd be like, oh, they're mean. Like, no, I love everyone there. I have a really close relationship with a lot of the people in like guidance and stuff, and they're all so sweet and they're all so helpful, and they all want the best for you. And it's really like a supportive community. And I'm also close with our school cop, and he has my back on everything because it, like sometimes after school when I have weightlifting, we go to our like our outside weight room, and he'll like drive me there on his little golf cart. And it's just super nice because I know I have all these people behind me, and I know they want the best for me, and I know they're supporting me. And in guidance, I have all these people telling me you can do this, like you'll get to like where you want to be. And they're all just so supportive, and I love it there. And all the teachers, they're super sweet, like, and they're all understanding. That's what I love about them too. Like, they're all very understanding. Like, if I come home from a tournament, sometimes I'll be like, listen, I'm on like 4 hours of sleep because I get home from Newberry because it's 5 hours away. I'm like, listen, I'm on 4 hours of sleep. I will do my absolute best to do this. But if I don't get it done in class, can I please finish at home and bring it to you tomorrow? They'll be like, yes, of course. Like, I understand. Like, they all support student athletes.
That's important. And I think the thing is, too, when we talk about academic counselors and those that drive you in a sense of like, okay, what's the next? Because, again, your class 2026, not too far off, is college. And so they're prepping you and guiding you for that. How are these academic counselors and student advisors so important to you as far as the academic side? Because you're holding a 4.0. That's not easy, especially with everything you got going on.
Okay, so I have one person in guidance who really helps me like stay on track is one of my guidance counselors, Miss Jody. And she really helps me through everything because she like helps me know that there is a path and that I will be able to go down any path I want to, because I work so hard to like get to the points where I'm at. And it's like she pushes me to do everything I can to make it to where I want to be. And it's like she'll check my grades and she'll text me and she'll be like, hey, like check this, check that. And it's very helpful, because sometimes a day, like I try to check my grades every day, so I know that if there's anything like I need to like tweak or something, or something I missed maybe when I was absent, I need to make up. I like to check it. But if I miss a day, sometimes she'll help me, and my dad does that too. He'll help me. And so it's very like good to have someone that's like there for you, and you're like, okay, do this, do that, and you'll stay on track and you can do this. Like it's very supportive. Like I have such a good support system where I'm at, and I'm so thankful for it.
Well, what a blessing. What a blessing to have that. You know, we're talking about Dwyer High School in a sense of just the school spirit that it has within the high school with all the sports. And again, all the student athletes supporting each other, and especially the student body that's there. There's a lot of support that you get from everybody there, huh? When it even comes to other student athletes that play other sports, right?
Definitely. My whole friend group in school. So I have two friend groups, and one of them is like cheerleaders, and then the rest is my softball players. So we're all varsity athletes. I'm friends with all varsity athletes. So we all get it. And we're always in season, all of us, because we all play at least two sports. And so we're always in season. And so we'll bring like two bags to school, for say, like I have my backpack, then I have my weightlifting bag, or I have my backpack and my softball bag. So, oh, another thing with that is my teacher, one of my teachers, name is Black. She'll let me keep my softball stuff in her room locked up, so I can not have to like bring it around the school all day. And she'll keep it for me, and she stands. And she actually helps coach the weightlifting, and she's super sweet.
Wow.
But everyone around me is an athlete, so we all get each other. We all do the most we can to help each other. And it's just great having like the same people with the same schedule and people with the same mentality and drive as you around you motivates you to do even better.
100%. How important that is. Well, I tell you, we're here with Sierra Cook out of Palm Beach Gardens, Florida, with Dwyer High School, class of 2026. We'll get into more about the softball. We'll be right back. I'm back here with Sierra Cook, and I tell you, Sierra, we were going to talk about softball. First and foremost, why the game of softball? You chose that sport. It could be other sports you play, but softball's the one. Why?
So the story is, when I was younger, I was like 5 years old, 4 years old, and I was watching the World Series with my dad, and the Red Sox were big Boston fans because both my parents are from up north. And so we were watching the Red Sox play in the World Series, and I was like, I want to be like them. I want to do that. I want to hit the ball. And so that was when David Ortiz was playing, and that's actually why I wear 34, because I really liked how he hit the ball, because he hit the crap out of the ball. And so I was like, I want to do that. And so my dad put me in softball. He put me in T-ball, and I just fell in love with it. Like, really, like, there is nothing I would rather do than play softball.
Love it. I love it. I love it. Yeah, it's a sport you love and you love doing it. So that's important. That's the passion that's involved. Now take me through some of the passion when it comes to, ooh boy, we're talking about this one, when it comes to training your body and working out. You just had leg day today. So take me through as far as what is Sierra doing to prevent injury, but also some things that are being taught to you on how to treat your body. That can even be nutrition as well. Take us through that.
Okay, so I'll like give you my week laid out. So Mondays, I have weightlifting, and then I have more weightlifting. So I do weightlifting for the school, and then I go to Palm Beach weightlifting with Coach Carl. And then I have conditioning for Dwyer softball. And then Tuesdays, I have weightlifting, and then I have travel practice at night. And then Wednesdays is the same as Monday. So I have weightlifting at school, then Palm Beach weightlifting, and then I have Dwyer conditioning, which is Dwyer conditioning on Monday is at SAS, which is in, it's at Jupiter Christian, and we do a bunch of agility there and like lifting and training and stuff like that. And then Dwyer conditioning on Wednesdays is like on the field, and we just run the bases, run the bases, run the bases, working on like base running and speed and stuff like that. And then Thursday, I have weightlifting and then Gators Jackson practice. And then Friday, I have weightlifting and I have my hitting lessons with Coach Sam on Friday.
You go. Wow. Plan.
And then
Now,
usually on the weekends, I'm playing a tournament.
doing something. Yeah. I would figure there's a tournament involved in there somewhere. Now, to handle all of that training and softball and schoolwork and all that kind of stuff, there are tools you use, Sierra, when it comes to that. Well, let's just touch on that really quickly. The tools that you use, you have to plan this stuff out. I mean, there's so much on your plate. How do you do that?
Yeah. So a lot of Advil. But no, I try to take a lot of like cold like showers and stuff because it really just helps like my muscles like decompress because it's so hot out all the time. Like it's so hot in Florida. Like that's part of why I want to go up north for school too, because I'm like, I need to get away from the heat. Like I'm sick of it. Like, but I don't know. I take a lot of cold showers
The humidity.
because I'm like, yes, the humidity kills, especially on turf fields.
Right. You were saying, I'm sorry.
And then and then I do a lot of stretching. Like a lot of stretching. Like my mom helps me with it because my mom ran track, so she knows how to stretch. Like if anyone does, she knows how. And so I stretch a lot and Advil. But and I try to eat really well. I try to eat a lot of protein, so a lot of pasta, which is carbs, but like it helps because it gives you energy. A lot of pasta, a lot of chicken, a lot of steak, a lot of eggs. I really like eggs. Yeah, I just try to eat the best as I can, and I try to use the time that I have off to just kind of recover my body, and I try to sleep as much as I can because sleep obviously helps recover. But yeah.
That's a lot. Wow. And tools you use. Obviously, the phone, a calendar, all these things obviously are part of your regimen in scheduling this. Is that true?
Yeah.
Yeah, gotta have it.
Like I have, so my dad has a family calendar set up, and so all my practices and stuff are on it. And so it'll be like my phone will send me things like practice this time, practice for this time. And I'm like, oh, gotta go.
Oh, I love that.
But all my facilities are really close to my house. So even though the times are very close, I have like segments of time in between each one where I can like go in my bed, do my homework, go to the next practice, go home, do my homework, go to the next one, and then do my homework.
It's
So
recommended.
I always get my homework done
Yeah.
and I get my practice done. How I do it, I don't know, but it gets done.
I mean, really what it is, it's a schedule and it's repetition. So you know what you're expected to do and have done. So that lays it out nicely
Yes.
for you.
And a lot of motivation and drive.
Lot of motivation because college is going to be right around the corner, like I told you. It's a different
Right.
environment. But going to softball, obviously travel ball and playing with your team at Dwyer High School, there's a difference. You know, there's the travel ball that's involved there, and then there's the aspect of your team. Take me through the differences. I mean, how does travel ball help you as a student athlete to get better? I mean, really as an athlete to perform well as a third base and outfield, training you for that and really learning other positions too.
So my travel team, we're very driven. We're very focused on the idea of, okay, we can all do this. Let's get it done. We can do basically anything we put our minds to. And we always think of not as like, we never think of like the team we're playing. We think of, okay, Like, we're playing a team, so we can do this. Like, as long as we put all our skills out on the table, that's all we need to do. We can do this. Because I think that our team, we're very talented. I love the girls I play with, like, all year round. Like, my high school team and my travel team, we're very close, both teams, and I love it. Like, I absolutely love the people I play with. And some of these girls I've been playing with since I was 8 years old. Like, my two of my teammates, Tori and Bryn, I've literally been playing with them since T-ball, and they're my best friends.
I tell you, familiarity, as I think about that and everything. And third base and outfield, I mean, there has to be some interesting things about those positions. What is it that you love out of each of those positions on the field, and how can you get better? We always talk about that. You're doing things well, but how can you even get better on those positions and know more about the game
So
positions?
for both of those, I have been playing outfield forever, like forever, like since I started. I played third base when I was young too, but then I stopped playing third for a little bit, but then I came back to it because I was like, wait, I love this. Like, I love playing the corner because it's a hot corner and I get so many balls, and I have an arm. So I like to show it off, and I think my overhand velocity is 65, and so I like, and I especially like covering bunts. I think it's the most fun thing to do because I'll get really close and I'll be like, okay, let's see if she can bunt on me, and I like the thrill of it. So I like the adrenaline, but. Yeah, and third base, it's very like you have to be very focused and very locked in because it's very quick. It's a very quick like place to play.
Want
And
to
with
ask
the
you.
outfield, I have loved the outfield forever. And I basically just it's like I'm comfortable in the outfield. But I do want to play third base for college because I feel that I have more like control over like I just like the idea of third base because it's like I'm able to speak to my pitcher, I can help calm her down, and I like having the voice on the field. And I feel as more as I could do that because sometimes when I'm in the outfield they can't like hear me out there. And I'm like screaming as loud as I can, but sometimes they can't hear me. But I love the outfield too, and I love when there's a runner on third and they try to tag up and I get them at home. That's my favorite thing because it's like it's just fun. And with the outfield too, I like to run. So I do a lot of running in the outfield and I love that. So
Sierra's trying to show off her speed. Come on now, right?
I got faster. I wasn't always super duper fast, but I got faster. I trained with my mom. Like I said earlier, my mom ran track in high school, so she helped me through all these drills she did when she was younger. And we'll do sprints in my like driveway, and we'll do sprint, 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 sprint. And it just helped me get so much faster.
Well, I'll tell you, when you speak about the game of softball and especially how you're around the action, right? You want to be around the action. You want to be with your teammates. You want to be involved. And I think that really comes across, especially to those future college coaches that are maybe watch this. Are there any recruiting is its own little thing, but have you seen much of recruiting for you even early in class of 2026?
Okay, so I go to a lot of camps. Like I do a ton of camps, and I try to go to the schools that I know that I would be interested in going to. And so this summer I was all up north and I did a few schools down here in Florida, and I've picked out like a few top schools that I would like love to go to, and that it's like I want to go to a school that wants me because I feel as if I'll be more valued somewhere where they want me and I'm not just begging for them. And it's also I want the school to be a right fit. I want to like the coach. I want to like the players, the team I'm going to be on. I want the environment to feel right to me. And I know when I find that school that it'll feel right and it'll click and I'll just know.
I know a lot goes into that, especially from a recruiting standpoint of getting all the letters, the attention, how you manage that. And I think that's one of the things that you and your parents will be able to manage well as it continues on. You're going to get different looks here and there from coaches, of course. If there was one word you could describe what you want to get out of this season at Dwyer High School, you know, and with your teammates, what's that one word that would describe the season?
Progress.
Beautiful. I love that.
Because, so our goal for our season last season was to win districts. We got really close. We were runner up for districts, and I do believe we could have won. We could have won. I think we can, and I think we will this year. That's the goal, and that's what we drive ourselves with, because we're like, okay, if we can win districts, we can win regionals. If we can win regionals, we can win state. So for us, it's all about, yes. It's all about just driving ourselves with each other. We motivate each other, and we do our best to push each other to be the best versions of not only ourselves as people, but players. And so progress is a huge thing, because all you can do is make progress. You can always be better.
Right. I'll tell you, that's beautifully put. And I think, boy, what a time with you, Sierra Cook, today. We appreciate you coming into Outside of Games, talking about you as a student athlete, really the training that's involved, and then, you know, also the people that are around you that support you. Huge. Well, we're here with Sierra Cook again at a Palm Beach Gardens, Florida, Dwyer High School, class of 2026, third base outfield. We heard a little bit about her positions today, why she loves those positions, 4.0 student athlete. And I tell you, watch for her, be on the lookout for her, because there's some exciting things coming her way as far as opportunities. And I think that's what we kind of discussed about today, about those opportunities. So Sierra, thank you so much for being on our program. We appreciate you.
Thank you.
I'm Alyssa DeCaros, and you're watching Outside the Games with your host, Kevin Minton.